Hello students, welcome to In 5 Minutes. We'll start with third sum on orthogonality and orthonormality. If you see this sum, it's some bit different because set of functions are given which we need to prove they are orthogonal for a range of minus L to L, and we need to construct an orthonormal set. So students, what is important here? If you see series, it starts with 1, then sin pi x, then cos pi x, then sin 2 pi x, then cos 2 pi x. That means you need to understand that they have started with sin 0. That means your n value has started with 0, 1. When it starts with 0, obviously your sin 0 will be coming as 0 and cos 0 will be coming as 1. So that's why it started with 1 and then sin, then cos, then sin, then cos. But here, when they say a set of functions, it is not only a one function. If you can see, there is sine also and there is cos also. So that means we need to consider two functions here. So I say, let. First I say fn of x. So let's define one function as sine of. It will be nothing but, see, if in a series it is directly going with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's not an even or odd series. It's directly a normal series. So I can write sine n pi x by L. So that is one of my function, and I need to define one more function because there is cos also. So I write gn of x, that is cos of n pi x divided by L. So now I start with my first condition for orthogonality. So when you prove for orthogonality, now understand students, you need to prove for f and you also need to prove for g. So let's start with, so I directly write a range, that is minus L to L. So fn of x, we will work for fn of x. So now fm of x into fn of x dx. If you find this, it should be equal to 0. So let's substitute. So I see here, minus L to L, fm of x is nothing but, here only substitute m. So I write sine m pi x by L. Fn of x write as sin n pi x by L dx. So now after solving this, I get, so again sin you need to write 1 by 2 integration minus L to L. This becomes cos of, I write first a minus b, so that will be nothing but m minus n. I just write m minus n because pi x by L is nothing but constant, pi x divided by L, and then minus cos of a plus b. So I write m plus n pi x divided by L and dx. So let's integrate this. So I get 1 by 2 here and sine of m minus n m minus L pi x divided by L, and this whole gets divided by m minus n pi divided by L minus, again same, I write sin m plus n pi x divided by L, the whole divided by m plus n pi divided by L. So here my lower limit is minus L, upper limit is L. So when you put L here, that becomes, see, both are sine terms. When you put L here, L and L get cancel, and sine pi series, again it becomes as a zero. The same works here with L. When you put minus L, that will be hardly getting me any change because sine of minus, it will be again pi series. So the final answer will be landing up into, that's equal to zero. So that's my first condition proved. My second condition is minus L to L, fm of x, the whole square, dx. Let's start with this. So that comes integration minus L to L fm of x the whole square. That means it will be sine n pi x by L the whole square dx. So that is minus L to L. This becomes 1 minus cos of 2 n pi x by L, and this whole gets divided by 2. Let's integrate this. So I get 1 by 2 constant outside. Integration of 1 is nothing but x minus. Integration of cos is nothing but sine of 2 n pi x by L. The whole gets divided by 2 n pi divided by L, where my lower limit is minus L. Once you put L here, so obviously L sin 2n pi, this will be 0, and for minus L it's also 0, the second term is 0. First term will be working as 1 by 2 L plus L, so that comes to be L, which is not equal to 0. So finally second condition is also proved. So this was the case for fm of x. Similarly, there is one more function, that is gn of x cos n pi x by L. So this also we need to check whether it is orthogonal or not.